It's time for a second page. We do have our list of recipes here, and that is of course neat, but when we tab a recipe, I'd like to display a details page where we can see the image a bit bigger and also view the list of ingredients, for example. Now for that, I will again run Ionic Generate, and you could now hit enter and select page from the dropdown, or you simply type Ionic Generate page, and then I'll create this in the recipes folder. So I'll start with recipes slash, because you can define a path to the component here, and then I'll name it recipe-detail. So recipe detail is the newly created component, and it is created in the recipes folder. So let's wait for this to finish, and it's done. It again gave us a new component folder with a recipe detail page component, which does have its own module for lazy loading. And in the app routing module here, we now also have a new path, which points at recipe detail and then loads this lazily. Now, of course, you don't have to keep that default setup though. And I want to have a different one. I want to have a path recipes, which loads my, well, recipes page module. But then I want to have a path recipes slash some recipe ID that loads the recipe detail page. Now, to make this work, what we can do is on that recipes route here, we can add children, which is an array of route definitions. And then the first child has a path of empty, so just recipes here. And this should now load the recipes page module. And then I'll add a second child here with a path of colon recipe ID. And this defines a dynamic segment in Angular, which means this can actually be anything in the URL. So recipes slash ABC, which would reach this, recipes slash 123 would too. But then we will be able to read that value on the component that is loaded for this page. So here I want to load my children. I want to load this route. So let's add load children here. And let's get rid of this recipe detailed path down there. So now this is the new routing setup I want to have. If we save it like this, it should recompile and it should reload and still show us the recipes. And if I now add slash ABC after recipes, then it actually loads the recipe detail page here. Now, obviously, we don't see anything on that page because we haven't added any logic, but this is how the routing will generally work now. Now, that is a good first step. Now, let's make sure that on the recipe detail page, we actually do display the details about a recipe. And for that, I need a global state management solution where I do store the recipes. Because right now, the recipes are stored in the recipes page component here. And that is nice for this page, but if I need that data in another page, I have no easy way of getting access to it. Yes, you could somehow import the recipes page component, but that is not how you do that in Angular, and it would actually lead to strange side effects and not be a good solution. Instead, we want to use an Angular service for that.